And we're here to talk about a couple of things. One is training with treats, and the other is how to accustom your horse to being bathed, okay? I know that sounds strange, but a lot of horses really don't know how to stand to be bathed, so we'll show you. All right, if you're interested in training with treats, you can go to trainwithtrust.manapro.com. And you can download some really great videos and some coupons for horse treat products. And you can see Lady C there doing a lot of her tricks and moves. It's very enlightening. So Lady's favorite flavor of treats in the bite-sized nuggets made by Manapro is peppermint. So whenever I start a session of either play or work with my horses, I always try and do something that will engage my horse, like a simple trick. Lady. Big smile. I'm actually a little too far to her side. Good. Cookie time. Okay? So when you're training your horse and your friends say, oh, don't train with food treats, we say, oh, yes, do train with food treats. Here's why. Helps keep the focus, helps keep her engaged, but it's the method that's important. So watch again how I do this. Lady, say her name. Ready? Tell her what I'm asking for. Smile. Smile. Good. Cookie time. So you say good and then cookie time. And never give a treat unless you do it in that sequence. Otherwise, your training will go south. So it's the structure of the training with treats that really brings the understanding to the horse. Okay. So a lot of horses cannot stand still. And standing and being patient is something that you have to train a horse. It doesn't just happen to start with. So Lady's being very nice and quiet today. 5 minutes ago, she wasn't. So how do you bring her focus back and engage her if she starts getting wiggly? Same thing I just did. Lady, smile. Good. Cookie time. Okay? Keep your sessions really short and be sure that you release your horse. That means end the session before she runs out of patience. Okay, the patients will get better over time. So, we've trained Lady C with treats for 14 years, and we believe that with kindness, kindness, yes, and a great method, motivation, that's treats, you can train a horse to do anything. Okay, so always take it slow, have a lot of fun. We're going to start with the bathing, and my favorite treats are right here, Manapro bite-sized nuggets, and my favorite shampoo is Corona, all right? So, if a horse has not had her legs sprayed before, we're going to start with that. Now, spray, we mean gently, okay? A gentle spray. In case you didn't know, horses' ideal temperature to be outside is between 44 degrees and 77 degrees Fahrenheit. It's really hot today in Texas. So if you live in a place where you have well water or it's really, really cold, just accustom your horse to it slowly because cold water on a warm body can be quite a shock. So with her, I'm going to do a couple things at once. I'm going to just get her used to the little spray of water on her legs, and she tolerates that really well. I'll get all four legs, okay? And just let her sit for a few minutes and get used to that. I like to start with the face, and I use a sponge, and here's why. I really don't like being sprayed in the face with water. When I was a kid, my brothers did that to me all the time. So I don't like it, and if I feel negative, she's going to feel negative. So I always do it with the sponge. Let her know that I'm here. Okay. Just wipe down her face. And don't ever use soap on the face. It is just way too easy to get it in the eyes. And you don't want to get soap or water in the eyes or the ears. So we just do it like this with a sponge. No reason for her to get upset. Okay. Then what we'll do is we will get the rest of the body wet after your horse will stand for the legs to be wet, it wet down. Then you can move up to the chest and the neck. Well, 5 minutes ago, I wouldn't have thought she'd be so quiet as she is right now. Okay, so Corona shampoo is actually made to work in a bucket of water, which is the way I like to bathe my horse, because they are, it's gentle that way, and you can conserve water. So I will wash down her whole body. We won't get the whole body because we're filming, but you can get the whole body wet. Then you take the mane over, and you can use the sponge. Be sure that you scrub down in the base of the mane, okay? Because if there's dirt and grime down there, you'll restrict the hair growth. Okay, so put your soapy water on your horse's mane. Move back to the tail. Walk up. Good girl, walk up. So what I do with the tail, walk up. Good girl. What I do with the tail, first of all, don't ever stand directly behind your horse. But I stick the tail in a bucket of water, and I'll scrub the top of it, still please, with soapy water. And the mane is soaking. Now the tail is soaking. Okay, I bet you knew this was coming. Private parts, part of every horse's bath. So if you have not accustomed your horse to having their privates handled, you might want to do it before your first bathe. Wash under the tail. If you have a gelding, get his sheath and do it very gently. If you have a mare like Lady, make sure that you can handle her teats. Wash them. Never use soap on private parts. Okay? Walk up. Okay, so when you start to rinse your horse after you bathe the whole body, again, gentle, gentle, gentle. Go ahead and rinse the horse until you don't see any more soap, until the water's clear, and then this is really important. You want to scrape your horse off. If you don't have a sweat scraper, go ahead and use the back of your hand like this. But the reason that you do that is because in hot weather, this water will sit on her skin. It will absorb heat, and it'll be like having an electric blanket on her when it's 98 degrees. Never a good idea. So bathing your horse should be a fun experience for you and her. And I like to make it fun afterwards, because usually what horses remember is the last couple of things that you do when you have them out. And maybe I'll tell you what we're going to do in just a second. Lady's going to show you her hula, which is one of the reasons I've been kind of laughing when I look at her this whole time, because this is one of my very favorite tricks. You ready, Lady? She held very still. Very good girl. Step around. Step around. It's great that she's got a clean bottom, right? You ready? Girl, cookie time. Come here. Come here. Cookie time. All right. Again, Sue De Laurentiis for Imagine a Horse and ManaPro. My horse, Lady C, who is also the ambassador horse for Friends of Sound Horses. And ManaPro, Bite Size Nuggets, her favorite. Big smile, Lady. Good girl. Cookie time. Thanks so much for joining us. And remember, for great training tips and coupons, go to trainwithtrust.manapro.com. You can catch Imagine a Horse on Facebook, and we have Lady C DVDs on sale right now. And please visit ManaPro on Facebook. Thanks a lot.